at the National Center for Autonomous Technologies with Anton Berge. Anton, welcome to the Community Grant Program.
Well, thanks for coming out today.
Yeah, fantastic facility here. Interesting, and I think maybe not always understood. I think a lot of people see NCAT, and they think probably just drones. And I think it goes even a little bit deeper than that to a centralized theme of autonomy. Can you tell us a little bit about the program?
We started out as Northland and with the UAS program, and so that's why the drone side of things always comes in first. As far as the National Center here, we're funded through the National Science Foundation under the Advanced Technological Education, and so really the mission is to help the the undergrad portions get through degree programs, and so I guess the big thing is we're doing it with the autonomy, the autonomous side of things is we're doing the air, land, and sea. And now we do the UAS side. We've got partners that help us with the other two sides. And so it's kind of bringing down the core pieces that, are utilized in all of them.
Okay, so basically you've got air, land, and sea, and where those three cross, that's where you guys come in basically. You're trying to teach the core skills that would pertain to any one of those. Is that correct?
It's trying to bring together what is the similarities between them, and then what is the differences. And so the goal is that it'll help with a student that might want to come in and just get started and be like, I know I like this stuff, whether it has a drone or has seen one or whatever the case might be, likes the technology side of things. And so this lets them get into it, and we're trying to make a degree program that will kind of help them get started. And then at that point, they can branch off to whatever side they decide they want to go towards. Okay. If they have a specific area they want to focus on, or really it's built into everything. So it's kind of it's an open track that they can go through.
Tell us a little bit about the land and sea. What kind of projects do you have going on, or what kind of technologies are you embracing that are part of the land and the sea?
One of our partners on the sea side is going to be MATE, and they are located out in Monterey, California. And so what they've got is they've got an underwater ROV competition. Okay. And so they've actually got a global network. I believe it's over 6,000 people that are involved with that one. They've got student competitions is a big thing of what NCAT is looking at on all sides of the fence. And so as far as the underwater ROV competition, they've got different designs every year on how they do it. They can kind of build it as they wish, or there is kits that they can kind of follow along with. Okay. And it's different pieces, I guess, each year for what the game is entailed. So I think this year is a focus on Crown of Thorns and okay. how they're invasive species. And okay. so it's kind of how do we go in and, how to go in and just kind of suppress them. And so it's interesting, just trying to work it through.
There's an element, well, more than an element, of STEM that works into the NCAT mission, isn't there?
I mean, really, it's across the board. With when you're talking about advanced technological education, I mean, it is going to be, we do a lot of STEM camps. And so, I mean, everything we do is technology driven. And so on the automotive side of it, you're looking at, I know down in the cities, we've got a lot of Nitro X races, stuff like that. We've got another partner out in CAT, which was another center before we were. And so they do the automotive side out in Michigan. And so they've got tons of different projects and events going on. I believe their next one is a Girl Scout event that is up on our website. So you okay. can always go check it out. The big thing for NCAT is bringing people together and showing what's out there. And so we've got lots of resources on our website to kind of bring people around to see what, if you're looking for professional development as a, faculty or whatnot, or if you're a parent looking for summer camps for your kids. I mean, it's kind of across the board that anything with autonomous technology, we like to be a part of.
Educators who are out there, if they want to bring this element into their classroom, you can help them out with that a little bit.
Yes, professional development is a big one. Our instructors here, I mean, they've got a lot of drone tech courses and other with the land and sea side as well. So they can bring in teachers and faculty members if they're trying to get it into high school or college, doesn't really matter. It's just what's out there that is better suited. A lot of things that are happening right now, I noticed, just in Minnesota, is the school districts keep wanting to buy drones. And so faculty are asking, and they'll go buy one and then realize you can't use it.
That's exactly right.
You know, it's not just a buy and fly. And so, and that's what we do, is a lot of our stuff is just teaching them, what do you need in order to do it safely? A lot of webinars and stuff that we put out there is just, what are the steps to do it right? Yeah, I think this was an $18 million donation.
Dang.
That came in, and then, you know, part of the stipulation is that they still use these, and so they still use them for training as well. And so we had them for a long time, and then they came in and grabbed some, and then at some point we'll get them back again. And the nice thing about having these partnerships with large industries like Northrop Grumman and others is that we're a two-year tech college in Northwest Minnesota. We don't have billions of dollars to buy a drone.
Right. So basically this is a small helicopter. I mean, this is a scaled-down helicopter that you can operate with a remote.
Right. This is actually an industrial drone made by DJI, the same people who make the Phantoms and stuff.
This thing's huge.
Yeah.
This was 100,000 or a little over by the time. I think the camera itself was almost 20, wasn't it? Or 15?
Plus they had to come out and train us on the whole system.
And this is carbon fiber, right?
Yes. Almost everything's going to carbon fiber.
What's driving autonomy? What's driving the move to have autonomous trucks, autonomous cars, autonomous delivery, autonomous drone delivery? What is it? Is it a lack of people to do these jobs, or is it a better, more efficient, more safe way to do it?
I think the latter part would be a huge piece of it. You know, as we're talking about the different technologies out there, somebody that's coming in with these newer drones and using them, you can buy one, and it's got so many safety features in it already, you're not going to stand outside of the airport and take it off because it knows better. Yep. And so, I mean, there's certain elements like that that is just a safety feature. As far as the ease, I mean, it's building it out, you know, helping people to make jobs easier, as well as it's not taking away the jobs. It might take away a job, but there's three more technicians that are working on that. And so it's just, it's a change in workforce, you know?
Yeah. A transition. Hey, Anton Berge, the assistant director here at the National Center for Autonomous Technologies. Thank you very much for joining us here, Anton.
Yes, thank you for coming out today.
And I'm Grant Nelson with another edition of Community Grant on Thief River Falls Radio.